Where y'all at, St. James? The man of God have confidence in you. That's why you're in the position that you're in. So now you gotta pray, God, give me the anointing to walk beside my mouthpiece. I can't get no help in this church. Give me the anointing to stand with my mouthpiece. Amen. That when his legs are tired from carrying the glory, that he can sit on me. Now, when the man of God say, I need everybody to be out for prayer.
All right, say that.
Ain't gonna be no singing.
Just prayer.
They gonna come in the hand of God. They gonna have everything else to do. They gotta go in the back. Bible said, Satan said to Jesus when he was vulnerable.
Go ahead, sir.
I hear the tone.
Yeah.
If you.
Watch your tone. Watch your tone.
I'm lost today. Satan said, if you be the Son of God, turn these stones into bread.
Yes, sir.
Now, some of you that are not anointed, you will try to fit and prove who you are with actions that's not becoming of he who God have anointed. Lord have mercy. Oh, thank you, Jesus. My problem is that how do we dance and shout and speak in tongue, but then got the nerve, I don't like her.
I gotta rearrange your church. Y'all take that for me. Thank you. At my church, I like to walk right along this thing here.
Wow.
It's impossible.
Well,
be anointed and then be hateful and spiteful.
Oh, I love him from a long handled spoon. The devil.
That's right.
Come on.
I forgave him, but I'll never forget. All right. Okay. All right. You have allowed what could have been in you to be corrupted by your past problems. Now the truth of the matter is, many of us in here ain't gonna tell the truth because a lot of us got on collars. Lord Jesus. But we got some stuff that we are still living that happened 20 years ago.
Come on now,
Jesus.
help us. Yeah, 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 yeah. We did a conference in Baltimore a few years ago, and the conference was, glory to God, healed without scars. And the theme was hope. Healing over past and present experiences. And the problem is that while we were in Baltimore, I didn't understand why we had so many problems, why the devil was fighting so bad. But then when it came time for folk to come to the altar, I begin to understand. And God is saying that there are strategic ways. Everybody say strategic,
strategic ways
to get over,
to get over
the devil. I'm tired of coming to church. At one time, we were the most dancingest church in Brooklyn. We don't do that now. At one point, every time the music, bang!
Go ahead.
Watch it, Bishop.
And I had to start sitting back to start watching.
That's right.
And God said, I want you not to watch them while they're dancing, but I want you to watch them when the dance is over. And it is when the dance is over that praise has moved us from praise into worship, and worship has moved us from worship to blessing him, that you will find those that's manufacturing their words, manufacturing the anointing. Because now they can't worship.
My God.
I'm in so much trouble here tonight.
Thank you.
The word
of
the Lord.
So, hold on. The Bible said that after Jesus defeated Satan and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. The Bible said that Satan did not leave him. He came back. Now here's the problem. What we do is, this is going to bless some of you. We dance on the first note, right?
Well,
because we think we got it. And then what we do is, we make excuse to validate what we're doing. So we say, I'm sowing seed. Hear me now. Hear me. So the other day, I heard something and I begin to search it for myself.
Gotta do that.
So when I search and I begin to go through, God told me to tell the people, be careful when you talk about sowing. Because everybody can't sow because they don't understand that in order to sow, you must be anointed. Now, what do you mean, Bishop?
You
come up here with all that. Let me help you. So now, so I did a little bit of study, Caleb. This is for you. I know you. So I studied about the seeds. But then it stood out when I got down, I scrolled down to the apple seed.
Yeah.
So I found, let's call it, that the seed, inside the seed, has cyanide in it. See, y'all missing this. So now, what happened?
happens is the seed that we sow, which is supposed to bless us, if you do not know how to handle it, the same seed that's supposed to bless us will now turn around and destroy us. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I need to be anointed right now. Oh, God, I need to be anointed right now, because you know what? The enemy wants us to believe, glory to God, amen, that every time we go through, in order to get out, you got to sow. You ever hear them crazy preachers? You want your deliverance? Sow. You want a miracle? Sow. Now, don't y'all up here get mad with me now. Don't y'all get mad with me. But a lot of preachers talk like that because they got to make their budget. So they're more concerned about the budget rather than you really being who God called you to be. So they tell you, you want a miracle? So no. I ain't got a soul to get no miracle. All I got to do is seek him. That's the scripture. Let me just skip over a whole lot of stuff here. Let me just skip over a whole lot of stuff so we can get out of here. So, the Bible said that the very last time that Satan came to Jesus, Barry, Jesus did something. He didn't break out in a... He said, Satan, get thee hence behind me.
I hear you.
For it is written that I will worship the Lord thy God, and him only will I serve. And the Bible said.
Yes, sir.
That then, and I'm going to be there in a minute. Yeah. I ain't got no voice tonight. Then Satan left him. And the angels came and ministered to him. But in the process, of the angels coming to minister to Jesus.
Well,
Jesus said, let this be an example to everybody, young and old, from 8 to 80, blind, crippled, and crazy. Let this be an example that if you want to get rid of the enemy out of your life, when the enemy comes in like a flood, submit yourself to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee. I want y'all to know God is looking for somebody that's willing to submit themselves to him and say, Lord, here I am. I just need your hand to touch me. And I heard the Bible say, glory to God. I'm going to begin a minute, Charles. I heard the Bible say, St. Luke picks it up and said that the Spirit of the Lord is up on me. He has anointed me to preach. I got to close now. I'm over time now. Oh, glory be to God. So what I need y'all to know is that when you are anointed for your right now, that don't just come with a praise, but it come with an assurance from God. In the book of Psalms, where David opened his mouth and said, sing now prosperity. Oh Lord, I beseech you. Sing now prosperity. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you trying to figure out why I'm still here. Oh, the reason I'm still here is because God invested something in me. Lord, I wish I was 100%, because I feel like preaching. I need you to know that the God that I serve, he's looking for somebody to say, if you need somebody, here am I. Oh Lord, send me. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, ain't no time to play, for I'm chasing my now anointing. Hallelujah. The enemy tried to get us out of position. Glory to God. And man to God, I almost did a backflip. If I was about minus 200 some pounds, I would have did a backflip in here. Because I've been dealing with my church about position and title. Lord have mercy. Not even realizing that the man of God was going to say something tonight that was going to click in my spirit. A lot of us in here, we're eager for titles, but don't realize, glory to God, that the title and the position carry two different anointings, or they're two different administrations. Glory to God. Can I tell y'all one thing? I ain't got no time to mess around with you, because the reality is I can't afford to miss my season. I've been in a storm too long. Is there anybody in here that can say I've been through something, but now that I'm out, I'm not gonna let the enemy kill my joy. Okay, Charles, I'm ready. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, I need a now anointing. I'm anointed for my right now. I'm anointed for the praise. I'm anointed. Somebody give God a praise. Somebody give God some glory. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, if I had to tell it, I don't have enough room. If I had to dance for all the miracles, not enough time. Because the reality is, as I look back at everything that happened, remember that song? That happened to me in my life. Lord, you brought me through that too. Shake the neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, I got a that too praise. Yes, sir. I didn't know how I was going to make it. Is there anybody's testimony?